Hi, I'm Alex, and in this video, I'm going to show you the third wave pre-built solution for synchronizing SAP Business One inventory to Shopify. This solution is configured using Bizweaver third wave's integration and process automation application. We will cover how Bizweaver gets your stock levels from SAP Business One, how the required JSON is built to send through the Shopify API, establishing a connection to that Shopify API, and how easy it is to customize this solution to fit your specific business needs. So let's go ahead and jump right in to see how our solution to Shopify inventory management works. The first step is pretty simple. It is getting our inventory levels from SAP, and this step provides us a lot of flexibility so we can get a specific warehouse or all of your warehouses and show what warehouse you want to show on Shopify. So you're not limited to only choosing a single warehouse or all your warehouses. You can pick and choose which warehouse you want to show on your Shopify store. The next step is going to be looping through those items that we got in the first step. That item then gets updated in our staging tables. The staging tables we already discussed a little bit in our orders video with Shopify and how they're a proven solution, and we'll discuss how to upload items or sync items from your SAP instance to Shopify from SAP in another video. But in this video, we're going to speak about how to update those items' inventory. So we update the inventory of each item in our staging table, and what we can do then is in our Versago application, we can then adjust the quantities of those items either individually, or we can provide a blanket update to them. And for example, we have this JB Office Print 1111. If we scroll over here, we can see that the e-com percent is actually, that's 100%. And what that does is it will show 100% of the total quantities you have in SAP. Say if you want to show double that, you would change it to 2, or if you want a half, you would change it to 0.5. So you're able to control exactly what you want to show on your Shopify store using our Versago front end to then change this percent to whatever you want. And it gives you a lot of control on what you want to show to your customers. So we can even adjust the website price. All of our integrations come with the Versago front end, so you can easily manage your items. And remember, later in this video, we're going to be going over how to handle errors that come out of the Shopify API, so you can manage them with every item uploaded. Though there are other ways you can use this instead of updating a staging table. Say if you don't want to use staging tables, we then can get the items directly from SAP using the UDFs that we already established in the integration. Or you can get the items directly from Shopify using another API call. And both ways are valid to let you know what you want to update. And if you get the items from Shopify directly, you can have it set to only update items that have changed inventory. So for example, if inventory hasn't changed on an item, you can then decide not to update it, because it would limit the API call, the post API calls that you're making, or the request to change those inventories if they're not needed. So there's a lot of customization available with Bizweaver and these integrations, especially with inventory management. The next is we're going to get those details from our staging table. Now, if you don't have a staging table, we would skip the prior step. There would be that modification of how we're getting that information, but we get those item details, we loop through those item details, and we update the inventory to our Shopify store. Now, to do this, we build JSON, and it's a very simple JSON string here that we're making. We're just doing the location ID for the item, the inventory item ID, which is attached to every variant of your items, and then finally, how many are available. So this makes it very simple what you want the available quantities on your Shopify store to be. And this is already pre-configured for you, so it's something that you don't have to do. It's already built. It's building the JSON for you, and then it will send it directly into our Shopify API. And all you have to do to this to make this particular portion of the workflow to work is to change the URL to your store. So it would just be this section of it. You change it, you drop in your URL, you create your credentials in our settings, the connection manager, and that's all done for you. It's ready to go. And then once the update happens, if it's successful, we'll then update the last time it was updated in our staging table, or if it failed, we'll update in our staging table that it failed so we can review why it failed and make those necessary changes. Once that's done, the merge happens, the pass or fail merge closes, and then we end our loop for the inventory, and then we end the loop for our items and the end the workflow. So with this solution, it's a kind of holistic way to deal with Shopify inventory management, which is very customizable for your business, and it makes it very simple for us to fit it to your specific needs. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to reach out. And remember, like and subscribe. Thank you and have a wonderful day.